Now the question is, the normal at an end of a latest rectum of ellipse passes through an end of minor axis if e to the power 4 plus e square equals to 1. So we'll consider this ellipse, which is x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equals to 1. And then at the end of latest rectum, so let it be this point, which is ae comma b square upon a. If we draw normal and it passes through one end of minor axis, which is 0 comma minus b, we need to find condition on eccentricity. Now we know that at this point we can find slope of normal. So all I need to do is I need to differentiate. If I differentiate, we'll get 2x into x dash upon a square plus 2y upon b square, and it is equal to 0. So slope of normal will be a square y upon b square x. Now y in this case is b square upon a, and x is a into e. So it'll be a square and then b square upon a, and it'll be b square and then x is simply ae. Now this a will cancel, this will also cancel, b square will also cancel. So slope of normal is 1 upon e. Now we can also find slope of this line using slope formula. So we can write 1 upon e equals, now this is y2 minus y1, so it'll be b square upon a plus b upon ae minus 0. Now in this case, e and e, it will cancel. So we can write a square and it will be equal to b square plus ab. Now b square is a square into 1 minus e square. So we can write a square and then it will be a square minus a square e square plus ab. Now this a square will cancel. We can cancel this a also. Then we can simply write b is equal to a into e square. Now we'll square again. So we'll square again. We'll write b square and it'll be a square into e to the power 4. B square is a square into 1 minus e square. So it'll be a square e to the power 4. A square will cancel. So from here we can say e to the power 4 plus e square, and it must be equal to 1, and that's your option number A. Now here the question is, if CF is perpendicular from center of the ellipse on tangent at any point P and G is the point where normal at P meets the minor axis, then CF into PG square is equal to what? So we have this ellipse. And then we have any point P at which we have drawn a tangent, and it says CF is perpendicular from center on this tangent, and G is the point where the normal at P meets the minor axis. So if we'll draw a normal at this point P, it intersects minor axis at this point G. Now we know that equation of tangent at any point P is given by x cos theta upon A plus y sin theta upon B, and it is equal to 1. Now we can find this distance CF, which is perpendicular distance from origin. So CF, it will be 0 plus 0 minus 1 upon cos square theta upon A square plus sin square theta upon b square with an under root sign. So we can write CF as ab upon under root of b square cos square theta plus a square sin square theta. So that is the value of CF. Now we will find the value of pg. Now first we will find this point g. Now we know that equation of normal in case of an ellipse is ax secant theta minus by cosec theta, and it is equal to a square minus b square. Now for this point on minor axis, we'll put x as 0. So if we'll put x as 0, we'll get y as b square minus a square, and then it'll be sine theta upon b. Now we have coordinate of this point g, which is 0 comma b square minus a square sine theta upon b, and then this point p is a cos theta and b sin theta. Now we'll find this distance pg. So this distance PG, it will be under root of a square cos square theta, and then plus this value, which is b square minus a square sine theta upon b minus b sine theta whole square. So we can write this as under root of a square cos square theta, and then plus, now here it will be b square sine theta minus b square sine theta. So b square sine theta will cancel. We'll get this as a to the power 4 sine square theta upon b square. Now from here we can take a square upon b square common. So it'll be a upon b, and then under root of b square cos square theta plus a square sine square theta. Now we'll multiply CF with PG. We'll get CF into PG as AB upon under root of b square cos square theta plus a square sine square theta into a upon b under root of b square cos square theta plus a square sine square theta. So we'll cancel. We will also cancel. So this is equal to a square. Now we'll square it. We'll get this value as a to the power 4. So a to the power 4 simply will be 49 square, which is 2401. So answer to this question is 2401. Now here the question is, normal at any point P on ellipse, x square plus 4y square equals 16. So we'll draw this ellipse, and its equation is x square upon 16 plus y square upon 4 equals 21. So it says normal at any point P, it meets the x-axis at point Q. So we have this point P, and which is a cos theta and b sin theta. A in this case is 4, so it'll be 4 cos theta and then 2 sin theta. Now we know that equation of normal in case of an ellipse is given by ax secant theta, and a in this case is 4, so it'll be 4x secant theta minus by b is 2, so it'll be 2y cosec theta, and it'll be equal to a square minus b square, which in this case is simply 12. Now for point of intersection with x-axis, we'll put y as 0. We'll get x as 3 cos theta. So coordinate of this point Q is simply 3 cos theta comma 0. Now we'll find locus of midpoint of PQ. So here alpha is 4 cos theta plus 3 cos theta by 2. So it'll be 7 cos theta by 2. And beta is simply sine theta. Now if we eliminate cos theta and sine theta, we'll get this locus as x square upon 49 by 4 plus y square equals 1. So that is the required locus of this point M. Now we need to find point of intersection of locus of M with latest rectum of this given ellipse. So in order to write latest rectum, we'll need to find value of E. So we know that B square, it is a square into 1 minus e square. So we'll get 1, and this is 4 minus 4 e square. So value of e square will be 3 by 4. So value of e is simply root 3 by 2. Now what is equation of latest rectum? Equation of latest rectum is x equals plus minus a e. So we'll put x equals plus minus a e. So value of a is 4. So it'll be plus minus 2 root 3. So that is, the value of x should be plus or minus 2 root 3. Now we need to find value of y. So we'll put x as plus minus 2 root 3. Then here it will be 4 and 4 16. So it'll be 16 into 3 upon 49 plus y square equals to 1. So that is, value of y is plus or minus 1 by 7. So point of intersection of this locus M with latest rectum will be plus minus 2 root 3 comma plus minus 1 by 7, and that's your option number C. Now the next question is, let F1, F2 be two foci of an ellipse, and PT and PN be tangent and normal at any point P. So we have an ellipse, and then there are two foci F1 and F2, and we have any point say P. So this is F1 and F2. We know that normal bisects this angle F1 PF2 internally, and in the same way tangent divides this angle externally. So this is N and this is T. So PN bisects F1 PF2, so that's correct. PT bisects external angle, so there'll be PT bisects angle 180 minus F1 PF2. So option A and B, they are correct. Now here the question is, maximum distance of the normal drawn at any point on ellipse from origin is. So we know that equation of normal at any point is given by AX secant theta minus BY cosec theta, and it is equal to A square minus B square. Now we'll find perpendicular distance from origin. Then perpendicular distance from origin will be A square minus B square upon under root of A square secant square theta plus B square cosec square theta. So we can write this as A square minus B square upon A square plus B square plus A square tan square theta plus B square cot square theta. Now we know that A square tan square theta plus B square cot square theta is always greater than or equal to 2AB. Using AMN GMN equality. So that means this expression, it is always less than or equal to A square minus B square upon under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB. So this is A square minus B square upon A plus B. So then this D is always less than or equal to mod of A minus B. So maximum distance of normal drawn at any point of ellipse is mod of A minus B, and that's your option number B. Now here the question is, if the normals at P, theta and pi by 2 plus theta meets the major axis at G and small g, then we need to find the value of PG square plus QG square. So we'll write equation of normal at point P. So equation of normal at point P will be AX secant theta minus BY cosec theta, and it'll be equal to A square minus B square. Now for major axis, we'll put y as 0. We'll get this point x as a square minus b square cos theta upon a. So coordinate of this point g will be a square minus b square cos theta upon a comma 0. So coordinate of p is a cos theta and b sin theta. And coordinate of G, it is a square minus b square cos theta upon a comma 0. Now we can write this distance, which is PG square. So this PG square will be a square minus b square cos theta upon a minus a cos theta whole square plus b square sine square theta. Now this value is a square and a square will cancel. So we'll get this value as b to the power 4 cos square theta upon a square plus b square sine square theta. Now here we'll take b square common, so it'll be b square upon a square, and then b square cos square theta plus a square sine square theta. Now what about qg square? Now in q and g, everything is same except for the fact that here theta is pi by 2 plus theta. So we'll just need to replace theta with pi by 2 plus theta. So we'll replace theta with pi by 2 plus theta, then qg square will be b square upon a square, and it'll be b square sine square theta plus a square cos square theta. Now if we'll add them, then pg square plus qg square, it will be b square upon a square. Now here cos square theta plus sine square theta will be 1, so it'll be a square plus b square into b square upon a square. So b square is a square into 1 minus e square, and then this is a square, and b square again is a square minus a square e square. So this a square will cancel, and here we'll take a square common, so it'll be a square into 1 minus e square into 2 minus e square. There's no option which matches this. So actually this option B should be a square into 1 minus e square into 2 minus e square. So right answer is the one which we have got in the solution.